Wow, I'm back. Okay, I'm so sorry. I have really bad reception here, so forgive me if I pop in and out, but thanks for watching. I'm at the Superwoman event in Beverly Hills at the Beverly Hills Hilton, and oh my God, can I just tell you that we have an amazing session going on right now. There's a phenomenal panel, and there's a really great set of speakers coming up this afternoon. And it's really all about creating a higher level of consciousness in this world, on this planet, where we're not caught up in these points of view or archaic concepts and ideas that there's any difference between the genders. You know, don't you think it's time that we actually realize that whatever you put your mind to is what you create and what you achieve? And it really has nothing to do with your gender. And I think once we actually make that decision that we're going to think from a higher perspective, that we're actually going to realize that we're all equal. It doesn't matter what color you are, it doesn't matter where you were born, it doesn't matter what you drive, it doesn't matter how much money you have. None of it matters, you guys, and it certainly doesn't matter what gender you are. So it's really time right now for self-love. It's time to go inside and reflect within yourself, to connect to your heart, and to stop projecting limitations that you were taught by someone else back in the day, you know, when you were a kid. Look, we're only taught by people who have points of view and opinions based on their programming and conditioning. And then, if we choose to adopt those programs, opinions, and points of view, then they become our reality. Now, if we take that and we project it out into the world, then it starts to reflect itself. So, really key, I know it's really tricky keeping the internet connection here, so I can't move around. It's really key to just make a decision to be conscious. Be conscious. Be conscious of what you think, conscious of how you let your emotions run. You know, there's a difference between feelings and perceiving. So most people in life react to how they feel. What if instead of reacting to how you feel, you started paying more attention to your perceiving and you used your intuitive side to connect into your environment and to perceive what's going on in that environment and then to calibrate accordingly? You would never feel like a victim. Never. You would always feel like you're in your power because you would be in your power. You would be creating what you wanted to create. You would be using your mind and you would be using your perceptions and your perceiving to be able to draw to you the experiences that you want to have. This has nothing to do with gender, okay? And it doesn't have anything to do with money. So it's just really time for us all to grow up as a humanity and take responsibility for the thoughts we think, the emotions we feel, and get some spiritual guidance, you know, create some spiritual maturity within yourself. Stop blocking and resisting. You know, resistance energy is what keeps us all from our happiness and from our fulfillment. So, interesting point of view. I have that point of view. That's a really great question that you could be asking yourself whenever you feel a little bit stuck. Just interesting point of view. I have that point of view. And also, I always start my day with all of life comes to me with ease, joy, and glory 10 times. And what that does is it blows out a lot of the blocks, a lot of the mental blocks, a lot of the emotional blocks. Stuff that actually gets right down into your neurology and keeps you from being the person that you want to be, the person that you have the capacity to be. So, one last really great question, and I'm going to dash because I want to get inside and see what's happening in there, is to ask yourself, like, who am I being today? Who am I being, and what is it that I'm creating from that place of being? All right, so there's some magic for you guys. You can use this in everything that you do, your relationships, your business, just going out and having some fun. You know, it's go out and have some fun. and start to laugh a little bit more and play a little bit more, and you'll find yourself being a whole lot more productive. All right. So just wanted to say, I love you. And maybe this is going to be the Deborah Peters Show episode 5 today, because I'm not sitting in front of my computer to knock that out for you guys. But if you go to my YouTube channel, which is Neuroengineering Institute, and there's tons of stuff on there. Lots of neuroscience, lots of meditation tools, my energy pull that you can use to bring in anything into your existence. Good health, great wealth, loving relationships, happiness, joy, fitness, all of it. All of it. Life is all of it. Life isn't some of it. Life is all of it, right? So thank you. Oh my God, I love you guys. Thanks, Carlos. Thanks, Tony. Hey, Robert, I haven't seen you in a long time. So thanks for jumping on here, you guys. I'm going to maybe circle back with you when we get the next break. All right, take care. Deborah Peters from the Superwoman Conference. I'm a Shiro. Talk to you soon. Bye.